Alex is gonna stand up in a harness, same way he fights his big tunas and Prince Edward Island, and he thinks he's gonna catch these fish. We'll see what happens.
Park on.
Broken line.
I want you to just pull up.
Set the hook.
Yeah, you're just setting the hook. Yeah.
This one probably. There's about to be a train wreck on the end of the line.
Yeah. Here we go. Let him eat it, let him eat it, let him eat it, let him eat it, let him eat it. Go, 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 now, now, now.
Yes! It's unlimited blank.
Look at that, guys. I mean, I just burned my hand. That line. Woo!
Hey guys, Josh Jorgensen here from BlacktipH Fishing, and we're here today with the Kanalgratis. And my good friend Alex here, he drove all the way down to Pennsylvania to come fishing with us. Over 18 hours. And are you tired, Alex?
No. 2 hours of sleep last night. I'm just excited. Adrenaline at this point, so I'm happy to be here.
Alex is gonna catch his first Goliath grouper today. You pumped?
Yeah, it'll be the first one from the boat. We've done some from land. Josh says it can't be done in stand-up, but we'll see what we can do.
Alex is going to stand up in a harness, same way he bites his big tunas and Prince Edward Island, and he thinks he's going to catch these fish. We'll see what happens.
All right, so I've already used this top shot a couple times, so I want to make sure it's good to go. So far, no bad abrasions or anything. But when you stretch out the line with heavy drag, sometimes it's best just to replace it. But everything else underneath is 200-pound braid. So that's the hollow splice connection. So basically the mono is fed into the braid, roughly probably 5 to 6 feet on this one. And it acts as a Chinese finger trap so it can't come apart. The only purpose that the serve at the end serves is to make sure it doesn't loosen, it doesn't get pushed down, and doesn't slide off. But you could actually not have this here, and it'll stay nice and snug the whole way through. So we're gonna wind some of this 200-pound back on to give it a little bit of stretch. You know, you don't wanna be fighting these big fish under heavy drag with no stretch. Comes ugly real quick. So it's a rota tip. It's a 360-degree rotating swivel tip. It's something new I'm trying out. The guys up at Strata Bay sent me some down so you can see how they hold up against these big fish. So no matter where it goes, the tip will follow the entire time. And another thing that we have on the rod, I'm actually going to fight bent butt since these fish are going to sit under us the entire time. We have a Winthrop adjusted butt so we can go from straight to bent at any time. Comes in handy when fishing for the bluefin up north. They'll fight away from the boat, but once they get under, they do their tuna death circles, and it's nice to be able to switch to the bent when they're right under you. So we'll get the connection here. We're gonna put it through twice, so the line, all that pressure is on two pressure points instead of one. If you put it on one, it will pop. So double it over, hold it still. That should hold. Just setting up for the Goliath, trying to get in the harness, making sure that everything's straight. The last thing you want to do is have a strap be like this. See how it's caught underneath? When you're hooked up to a fish, you want to make sure everything's perfect. You want nothing going wrong because it is dangerous. We put a leash on the back of the harness to make sure if I get pulled, if I lose my balance and go over, that I'm not going in the water too far. The last thing you want to do is be hooked into your reel, be fighting with heavy drag, heavy line, and not come back up.
So we're gonna drop the bait down now, Alex.
Yep.
We cranked the reel up. This reel doesn't have a lot of drag, but Alex just beefed it up pretty good, so we'll see what happens. Here we go. So Alex, he's gonna hit the rod. He's gonna, like this, he's gonna be bumping it. And if it's a real big one, he'll just swallow it and go straight down. Uh-oh, here we go. Ben Chancey shows up.
To it.
Oh, man. This is gonna be good. Oh, man. Hey, still there?
I'm not spotting very well, Josh. But
hey, still there? No, I'm just watching, man.
Yeah, I know that's the issue.
Come on, Ben. You're gonna donate some live bait to us? Oh, man. Okay. I'm almost out of sabiki rigs. Oh, Alex, bring that up. It's game time now. You're nervous, aren't you?
I mean, if you weren't nervous, I mean, not nervous in the sense of I'm worried about getting in trouble, but I'm jittery in the sense of, you know, there's about to be a train wreck on the end of the line.
Yeah, I'd say so. You see the jacket on? Goliath's right here. Alex, hold on, ready? It's gonna happen right away. It's gonna happen right away. Get that jack off the ladder.
It's already off.
Okay. Okay, we were about to move, and then I started seeing the bait get closer, and I said, there's gotta be some bonita around here. So, sure enough, after like 3 or 4 casts, the bonita showed up. Now watch this, guys. The Goliath was following this fish. He's sitting underneath this boat right now. So, this is gonna happen extremely quick. Here we go. He's gonna get it right now. He's got it. Oh. Oh.
Getting all worked up, Josh?
Oh yeah.
Exciting?
I'm pumped, man.
Yeah, you're pumped. I can hear that.
Here we go.
I can't see him.
Seems right here. Trust me, they ain't going nowhere, bro. See that jack? They didn't want that jack, man. They want the bonita. That's what they want. Here we go. Let him eat it.
Go now.
Oh my gosh. What? He's still on there, dude, I think.
Keep going. Dude, it's gone.
Oh my gosh, the fish is still on there. Ouch. One sec. Come on, dude, we got the rod. Come on. Just a big fish. Come on, dude.
Yes! This is unlimited blank.
Look at that, guys. I just burned my hand. That line. Woo! Now you know why we fish e-glass and not graphite. So, I mean, he popped 200 like it was sewing thread.
Yeah, that popped near the blank, though. It was rubbing. I think that's what popped it, you know. It wasn't, you know, down there by the fish. It was actually, line no longer touching guides and just gaining too much friction. You can feel it all through. Just pop, so expected, but
that's awesome. All right, so now I'm gonna give you my rod. You're gonna try my rod now, right?
I don't want to break it though.
You ain't breaking my rod.
Okay, he said I won't break it.
You ain't breaking my rod. Oh my gosh, look at those flying fish. Look at those flying fish. Guys, something serious is around here right now. Something just came in here.
Unlimited 4-foot United Composites. Unfortunately, the company doesn't exist anymore, so this was one of 2 blanks left that I could find. I searched for a while to find these. Purely for this reason, and you see it right there, there's no high stick, just a giant fish, you know, bent butt, so the rod has a chance to lay out, and I just, you know, I gave it all I had, and the rod couldn't hold.
So, you know, that's the great thing about being a rod builder. Yeah, I like to test these before, you know, head them out. And looks like we need something a little bit bigger, huh?
I was a little worried there for a second, man, because when that rod broke, and you start, I mean, you're lucky that fish didn't keep going down. He stopped for a second.
Yeah.
Because that could have been a disaster.
Yeah.
They're down there. He's gonna come get it.
Dude, I'm worried about your rod.
It ain't breaking.
What if it breaks? Will you yell at me?
Pete will give me a brand new one. I won't yell at you.
Oh, dude, this is a stand-up butt, too. Get interesting.
Oh, man.
It's twisted on top. Get
off. Oh, my gosh. Let the shot right away.
Yeah. You're good.
Fish would have picked up and would have taken the whole thing down. And I would have been feeling every bit of the fish. Oh,
that would have been bad, bro. We might have to switch the... Oh, you got it.
What?
We're gonna have to switch the outside of the boat. The current's moving north. Reel up. Because they're going to pop us underneath the boat. Yeah, so what I need you to do... Here, I'm going to walk this around to the other side of the boat.
You just can't...
Park to us.
Broken line.
Dude.
What was that, a bull shark?
I think it was, but now I'm turning it was a glide because it broke him off.
Heard your knots?
No, he got, no. Yeah, snipped, slipped. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh, it was a glide. You should have gone.
Wasn't prepared.
This guy's getting beat up, man.
That hurt my back.
It's because your rod didn't.
Bro, when you put a bait in the water, you got to be ready all the time.
Yeah, okay.
You of all people should know that. You've already broken one rod today.
I know.
Hold it up. Woo! That's a strike, guys. That's not even full drag. I think our line...
I don't think it can take it.
I mean, this is a 200-pound test, and it's breaking every time. This is a sad day. We're going to run out of line before we get the fish. All right, if you lose another one after this one, because you're costing me a lot of money now with my rigs and my time, I'm gonna show you how it's done, but I'm gonna hit you with a hand line, all right?
All right, well, I'm up for hand lining them too, Josh.
I know, but you gotta prove to me you can get them in the stand-up harness first.
Hey, I'm doing everything I can. The rigs just aren't living up to it.
What's happening? Alex, you better hold on, my friend.
The bull shark. The two big bull sharks here, two big goliaths.
Like Alex, really, you see inside that goliath?
Yeah, that was a big one.
Oh my god, that was giant, dude. Get my hook back.
You getting red, Alex? Wow. This is going to be fun. You're in for a ride if you catch that big one. Wow.
Ooh. That one's gonna pull drag. Did you see how big that's like 700 pounds?
Was it?
Did you see how big it was?
No.
Oh my gosh, bro. Dude, it was as wide as, it was bigger than the boat in width. Hey, this is gonna happen very, very, very quickly. Here we go, ready? Keep him alive.
Wait.
I know. I'm just trying to get him going.
Alright, Josh. You're gonna have to do this. Stand up here though. You're gonna have to do the same thing.
He's right there, the giant, dude. The giant.
Get on this right side.
Oh my gosh. I wanna get a surface strike, ready?
Yeah, I need you to get on the right side of the raft.
Okay, ready?
Mate, just make sure you get it, Josh.
What?
We need to get the fish now.
Okay. Here you go. He's got it. Hold up, let him eat.
Okay. Surface strike, you need to just let me know.
He spit it out. Dude, he missed it.
Big was it? You guys are scaring me. Oh my
god.
There's something down there that's giant. Here comes. No, that's a little one. He's nosing it, hey? Here, hold up. Ready? Watch it. Oh, bull shark right there. Bull shark. Oh. Ready? Here we go. Bull shark. Let him eat. Watch the glass scare him away. Ready? See the glass scare him away? Oh. to the glass. They're fighting over it. There's two bull sharks. There's two bull sharks. Bull sharks got it. Bull sharks got it. Bull sharks got it. Here we go. Ready? Bull sharks got it. All right, you got him. This is a shark now. This is your kind of game. Come on, bro. You got him. You got him. That's pretty serious in there, right? I'm sure didn't go. I'm gonna help you out.
Oh, we're good.
You good?
If he goes behind the boat, we're gonna be in trouble, though.
Josh. Here, I'll be your turn. I'm gonna help you turn. Come on. No. He ain't gonna. Dude, we got him. Hold on, ready? I just don't want him to get stuck. All right. You ready? No. There you go. We turned up. There we go. We turned. We got him.
We're moving the whole boat here.
Nice fish. Let's see if full shark you ever caught.
This one, probably.
Back it back on a little bit. You got it, bro.
Come on, man.
You got this, man.
My net.
Come on, bro. You got this. Come on, man. You got this.
The plate is on.
Dude, how would you hold the rod with that hand? And I'm gonna go from behind and hold you, right? Come on. Stand in the boat now. Stand in the boat. Very bad. Very, 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 very bad. Okay, now. Hold on, dude. I got you, bro. You're not going in. It's a bull shark, dude. It's not a scary thing. Come on. We don't want to take him in the anchor. Come on, keep going. Come up. Come on. Come on, Alex. You got him. Come on. He's right here. I'm with the gloves.
Yeah, you're good.
Josh, you good?
I know, good. I'm just getting close. Hold on.
Keep him there. You're good, Alex. You're good.
Woo!
You got it, man. Wow. You broke her. She's all done.
It's a nice fish,
wow,
man.
That's
your
fish.
Biggest bull shark?
Biggest bull shark.
It's a serious fish.
Now, watch the swivel, hear it? Now back to drag up.
Yeah.
We got him, dude, he's done, bro. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I'm stuck.
I got him.
Yeah.
So damn hard. It's almost out. There it is. Oh.
Woo.
Nice fish, dude.
Trying to pull drag and it couldn't.
Yeah, they're not as strong as the Goliath groupers.
No, nowhere near, but it had a lot of weight to it, so it definitely made me tired. I'm beat.
The fish was definitely over 300 pounds.
Yeah, well,
definitely.
I would say. Easy.
Yeah, that was a nice fish.
But,
you ready to catch another one?
I'm a little tired. I think I need a break.
I think it's lunchtime. Lunchtime.
Well, we're trying to catch bait underneath this boat here. There's like 10 Goliaths underneath it. And every time we catch a bait fish, the Goliath tries to eat our bait fish before we can even get it into the boat. So whether it's a big bait or a little bait, they're trying to eat it.
You ready, Ben?
I'm ready.
Let's see this. No.
Alex, you need gloves. Yeah, that's good. Gloves are good.
All right, Alex, so we're going to do a hand line now. You got beat up on the rod.
Yeah, my legs hurt.
Does your back hurt?
I did my lower body workout. I want to work my upper body today now. No, back's pretty good. Legs are beat up though from hanging on the side, so.
Okay, the most important thing right now, do not ever step on the rope.
Too bad.
You'll die.
Are you spotting the rope?
I want you to just toss that in and ready? And just hold that rope, right? Just toss that in. I got the rope back here.
Any techniques you would like to let me know.
Just drop it down.
Is it all right to let it ride on the side of the boat?
Leave your hand out like this. Let him eat it. Yeah, let it ride on the side of the boat. And when he grabs it and he's taking it good, you're just going to pull up like that.
Pull up?
You're just going to pull up.
Not pulling back?
Nope. Just
can I pull back?
No.
I wanted to.
Here, ready? Like I want you to just watch this. You throw the bait in the water. Yeah. You let it sink. Yeah, I can do your hand, hold your hand like this. You're gonna become a fishing rod.
Yeah.
Okay? And when he takes it, I want you to just pull up.
Set the hook.
Yeah, you're just setting the hook.
Setting the hook.
Yeah. That's all it is, right?
All right,
give it a toss. Don't step on your own rope.
Don't step on my own rope.
Yep, never do that.
Bad news.
There you go. Now let it sink, let it sink, let it sink.
Let it sink more.
Let it sink like 10 feet. Come on, bro. Get him. Come on. Come on. Get him. Come on. Come on. Come on, bro. Come on. Come on. Get him. Get him, man. Oh! Let me scream if you need help. Do not wrap your hand.
No.
This is a big one, dude. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Get him. Get him. Get him. Oh, he's a nice one, dude. Oh yeah. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. It's right here. It's right here. Oh, it's a nice fish. Oh yeah. Oh, watch out. He's gonna go nuts. He's gonna go nuts. Oh man. Okay, that's a caught fish.
That was.
But we're gonna do another one, right?
That was like 10 seconds.
You gotta finish. You gotta use the other. You gotta make it happen.
Here, I'm gonna help you out. Ready? He's got it. Come on. You got him. Come on. You got him. Come on. Get him. Oh, come on. Bro, your rods are too high, man. Come on. You got him. Got him. He's right here. You got him. Let me get the gloves on. Oh! The gloves on. It's a nice fish, dude. I mean,
nice fish.
You couldn't handle the big one, so God gave you that one. So, here we go. We're gonna release this fish now. Nice fish. Still fought hard for that size, didn't it, Alex? Pretty impressive animal, isn't it? Oh, he just said thank you to you. Thanks, man. Thanks for letting me go.